Isu o, Big Six, Udaya kinan. Ispista po ani, Utaki, Akes Gout kay.
Wolfe and the Sparrows, by Brandon Vickerd, was inspired by an existing statue of General James Wolfe, sculpted by John Massey Rind in 1898. The original sculpture was gifted to the City of Calgary by Glenbow Museum founder Eric Harvey, and now stands in a park in the community of Mount Royal. General Wolfe led the British Army to victory over the French during the Battle of the Plains of Abraham in 1759.
I was really drawn not just to the opportunity to make something for the community of Inglewood, but to make something with the community of Inglewood. This process to realizing this work has been one of community consultation. So we entered it not with set ideas of what we wanted to see, but instead connecting to the people who lived here to identify themes and ideas that were important to them. And out of those consultations and those conversations, I worked with Public Art Calgary to refine the idea until 2 years later, you have Wolfe and the Sparrows standing before you.
The whole idea that major infrastructure projects like this bridge are not only being spent on major infrastructure, but are also being spent to interpret and think about and communicate through art our particular project of civilization. And the idea that Inglewood has to remain a place for everybody. And that, I think, is corely connected to our project of truth and reconciliation as well. When we acknowledge that we are treaty people on this land, what we are acknowledging is that this land has a millennial history, a history that dates back into time immemorial of different people meeting on this landscape, and instead of engaging in combat and warfare, engaging in the project of building community together.
Brandon engaged with representatives of the Inglewood community to develop the concept for the artwork. Participants indicated they would like to see a piece that was historical in nature, represented challenging views, and explored the relationship between settlers and Indigenous peoples. The sculpture includes a text translated into French and Blackfoot. The Blackfoot translation was made by local artist and elder Sheldon Firstrider.
So when I was asked to do the translation for the statue, I really did not know exactly what I was going to translate. So I asked my elders about the statement that I have given, and they approved. And so now we are using a syllabic alphabet. And so it's such an important, because this is our first recognition by the city of Blackfoot syllabics. Because not only is the city recognizing it as a language, but also recognizing the Blackfoot people. And so when we're looking at General Wolfe and what he did, the translation really just says he is a warrior and the birds were his spirit helpers. The sparrow he came with, and they have flown away with his soul back to England.
Wolfe and the Sparrows may first appear to be a traditional bronze monument, but as you move closer, a flock of sparrows, a bird species native to England, explodes from the figure, distorting Wolfe's head and shoulders. The sculpture doesn't celebrate a historical figure, rather it is transformative. Wolfe and the Sparrows challenges citizens to explore how our ideas of nationhood evolve as we expand our understanding of the past.
I'm really, really proud of it, even though I don't really know General Wolfe. All I know is that he was part of the Plains of Abraham and defeated the French. But we're all still here, the English, the French, the Spanish, and of course the First Nations. We're all still here. We all should start to look at each other in a different way than one of superiority, because that's the complex that we all have to deal with today. And trying to explain it to your children when you know that this is the truth and reconciliation is the way to honor that truth.
just standing here, how many people are walking by, stopping on their bicycles, stopping as they walk along, having a conversation about this piece, to think about the history of this country, the Battle of the Plains of Abraham, 1759, the most essentially important piece of our colonial history, and then adding the sparrows and the absence of a head to the statue and having it faced east, that perspective, it just adds so much more to the conversation. So that ability for people to gather and have a conversation about art is so important.
I love the fact that it becomes part of the landscape as a piece of public art. It's going to change, it's going to evolve. The patina will change on this. It will evolve, it will devolve. Birds may create nests up in the top of Wolfe's head. And that's wonderful. And it becomes something much greater than the sum of its parts. It invites conversations. It invites perfect strangers to come and talk about their commonly held values, the things they disagree on as well.
The concept for Wolfe and the Sparrows comes from many conversations and engagement with Calgarians from communities near the artwork. This collaboration was essential in the development of the piece.
But I have never experienced a community that's been so welcoming and so willing to offer opinions and insights into the project, and that's been extremely valuable to me. So when I look at this piece, I don't see my sculpture or my public artwork. I actually see ideas and values that have been passed on to me from the communities. So.